Namaste, Salaam Alaikum, Sasriyakal. Welcome back to another session with your Vaashef at Vareva.com. And today I'm going to make nice fish curry. Take some red chilies, ones that give you nice color also. In that, add some fresh coconut, some coriander seeds, garlic and ginger. First, we're going to make a paste out of this. So the ginger garlic with the coriander seeds, the red chilies, the fresh coconut. This is what is going to be our base gravy. And I'm going to use kokum. See, kokum, you get a couple of varieties. The one kokum which will give you very nice color. The other ones are dried, we have just put hot water in it. This gives the sourness. So for the cooking of fish, we use lot of souring agents. Sometimes we also use raw mangoes, the mango powder. Tamarind is the number one favorite in south of India, but kokum is another one. But throughout the Europe and every other places, they use lemon juice mostly. But we are going to make juice out of this and add in this. So first, let's make a paste out of this. The paste is all ready. We are going to convert that into gravy. But fish, you know, people cook it differently. Some people, they love to add the raw fish into the gravy. Some people like to fry it. So if you want to fry it, take some coconut oil. And now, take the pieces of the fish and fry them. Usually people add little bit of turmeric, but I'm just doing it like this only. First the skin side and the other side. I always like prawns to be cooked separately like this because I don't want to overcook the prawns. But the fish will hold the piece together well when it is slightly fried like this. Once the fish pieces are slightly fried, take them and put it on the side and we are going to make the gravy. We're going to do the tempering with mustard seeds, cumin seeds and some fenugreek seeds. Not too much. Add onions on the side and the curry leaves. The flavor comes out when they fry in the oil. Once they sizzle, mix it with the onions and always add a little bit of salt. And we're going to cook this for a minute. You want the onions to be slightly colored. Add the green chilies, fry them a little bit. Even those fried green chilies give nice taste to it. And now the paste of the coconut. You want to just add, and I think it is slightly thicker, just add some more water. Now we're going to cook this for like 3-4 minutes, after which I'm going to add the kokum water. Now look at this nice gravy with the raw coconut, everything. In this, we're going to add the kokum water. This kokum water will give the nice sourness that what we need into this curry. But I just want to let this cook for another 2 more minutes, and after that I'm going to introduce the fish. After you add the fish, you don't want to boil it too much. You want just to simmer for another 2 minutes. And then this dish will be ready. Always check the salt, everything before you add the fish. I'll just let it simmer for another 2 minutes. Look at the gravy and just add the pieces of the fish in it. Make sure that the fish is literally soaking in this gravy. And we're going to let it cook for another 2 minutes. Put the lid on. Let this heat, the steam, everything make this fish perfect. I know you have a question. This is a sea bass, that is Bhekti fish, which has got a single bone. The fish actually grows into a very big size. When I was in a 5-star hotel, the kind of fish we used to get used to be like 60-70 kgs. Those days it was heavier than me, but today anything shy of 90 kgs is less than me. But let us cook this for another minute and then enjoy it. Fish curry is all ready. I don't have the patience today. So we have this nice gravy along with the fish piece, tender fish. Pieces of fish is nice and ready, the gravy. I always enjoy this kind of fish curries with the rice. Even the gravy, it gets that nice fishy flavor and super. And the fish, look at it, nice and white, bright inside and the nice reddish outside. Keep cooking, enjoy great food and keep saying Vareva.